Hi everyone, welcome back to the Scriptcase Macros course. Today we have another video on the SC block display macro. So my name is Nate Carpenter, let's go ahead and get started. So this macro determines whether or not to display a block in its fields. So a block is just a set of fields and items, so you can choose whether or not to display those conditionally. So here's the macro, you pass in the block name, we'll look at some different blocks, and then on and off. So display it for on, and then for off is going to turn off the display. So here's an example of how to do that based on a field. So this is an if system, and we're actually going to copy one of these here, and let's take it over to Scriptcase to use. So I've got a form here, just a basic form. I've got a few fields, and then I've got some address fields here. So these fields are going to be displayed in a block. So let's go to layout blocks. And I've got this address block right here. And if I go to edit fields, you can see how to put those fields in the block. So I have the main block here and then the address block. And then everything below this is not shown. So there's my two blocks. Let's go ahead and display this, run this so you can see these. So as you can see, you have the name, last name, email, and then the address blocks. We're going to make it so that they have to enter and the user has to enter in the first name and the last name before the address block is shown. So we're going to do that in an ajax event. And on a regular event. So we're going to do this on load. So this is when it's initially loading. It's going to check whether or not the first name and the last name are displayed. So we're doing an if condition, and we're going to check if each of those fields is empty. So first name, field name for that is first underscore name, and then do an or. So if either of them is empty, make sure I format this or correctly, and then do the same test empty on last underscore name. Put it in the curly braces there. So that it gets the value out of the field there. Make sure first name is in curly braces as well. And let's go ahead and open that if block up and copy in that code from the documentation. So SC block display, and we need to put in our name of the block. So that's ADDR underscore block is what I named that. And then off, we need to turn it off since one of those is empty at least. So it's going to turn it off. So if we run this now and we go to add mode, it will not display that block. So we go to add, and as you can see, first name and last name are blank, so the block is hidden. So now we need to make it so that it can turn on when they do enter the first name and last name. So I'm going to copy this code, and we need to put it in an ajax event so that it can look at when that first name and last name changes. So we're going to go to ajax event, new ajax event, and we're going to put it on last name. We could put it on both first name and last name, but we're just going to worry about last name this time around. Pass through the last name and first name values through to the ajax event. Let's go ahead and copy those in. And we just need to change this logic. So now we're looking if it's not empty, and they both have to be not empty. So we're going to do an and instead of an or. So first name is not empty and last name is not empty. And so then we're going to turn the display on for that block. So that's the only thing we need to change is change the off to on. And now when they click out of the last name field, as long as these values put in for both first name and last name, it will display the address block. So run this, click add new, enter in a first name, I'm going to do John Smith, like so, and then click out of this and it should show our address block, and it does. So there is our address block all set up and ready to go now that a name is entered. So that's how you use the SC block display macro to hide and show blocks conditionally in Scriptcase.